Friday after the celebration of the poster 600. Today, Sunday 22 and 23 August. I'm creating the poster number 601. So let's remove the January 1st there by and replace it by August 23. It is the poster 5. Oh my god, 601. Remove that 2020 there and place it near the title. Area. I save my document. Command S, and we are going on Blender 2.8. On the previous miniseries Gold Brain, I already have been working on the brain, so today I will only have to change the color of the brain, and I already set my lighting things there, and I want to change the brain color with something darker. Let's place there okay. Where my cursor is there, yeah. not gray. Okay. Yeah, why not? It already changed or what? It's there. Hey, I think last time I used Blender, this option was on the top corner there. Change faster. I'm using the render EV. And I want a dark plane. So I choose the color. Okay, a very dark gray. Looks fine. Glossy PSDF. Okay, now it's not dark enough. Come on, Blender. Well, I think it's my computer now. We really have a problem. Here we are. that's dark enough. We want it maybe metallic. See what happens on the brain there. That's too metallic. Yeah, just play with the option. Blender is a free 3D software, is open source, means you can use it totally freely. It is a little bit complicated with a lot of different options and crazy stuff to do, but there are many tutorials you can see online and you can follow them and get a result relatively easily. That's why Blender is pretty interesting. So I'll save my file, save as black brain. Black and the brain done. Save as on my desktop, of course. Now that it's done, I make a render. I go there, I click render image, and I have to wait a moment for the Blender render. Fortunately with Eevee it's go much faster than the previous engine render. Oh, I already don't remember the name of this one. Yeah, I just don't remember the name. Blender Eevee. No, I don't remember. So let's wait a moment that the render is generated, and takes time to do it. Just a little bit time. And Blender is really pretty interesting, and it's not that complicated after many times you use it, really. The first time I remember when I use Blender for do some little stuff, really nothing crazy, and I understood nothing at that time. And many years after that, I really start to invest myself, but not so much, and I already can make some relative render, good render. It's not perfect for sure. When I saw a tutorial online, I can see they are really good, and when I come up with a result like the gold brain, yeah, just so or not so nice, but still nice to use it and work it again on Photoshop to get a better result. And 3D is pretty interesting for graphic design, I think. It opens many possibilities. after, if you want to do special stuff into Blender, it really demand many skills, and I think for get those skills you need a lot of practice, a lot of learning. Like for sculpting stuff, or you should be skilled and talented at the same time, which is probably not my case. And for that 3D software, and it's possible to do stuff whatever your level is. If you follow along with a tutorial, you can learn things. And now I am I'm learning, and I'm going to do things I want by myself relatively easily, except when I'm looking for something very precise on the internet, that comes the problem, because when you have when you are starting to go deeper into a software and looking for something details, it's very difficult to find it. You have to find the right formulation of your problem, describe it well, to search on Google and find the right answer. And usually there are not only one answer, so you have to test them. You have to make a synthesis, an antithesis, and synthesize the all together. And it can take time. I come back when the render is generated. So I see you very soon, I think. Oh, if I can touch to close it. Yeah, there, see you. Second after I cut the video, the render of the brain appear. So I register the file there, and as you can see, there is a brain, a black brain, the exact same than the gold brain, but in black. You can do it in Photoshop, but I wanted to open Blender a little bit. So I continue to explore with the brain more, and let's get started. This poster 601. Let's get it by half, but on a diagonal way. Here now, here looks relative equal. No. If I copy this layer in case if I need it, Command C, I erase the part of the brain there. Copy, Command V, here, not bad. And there I am. Maybe Maybe it's not the better way. Maybe it is. I think it's relatively good. Looks good. Yeah, it's good. It's good. Let's create a geometric line. Or a square behind the brain, rectangle or something like that. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Rectangle tool. Let's make the lines I was talking about just before. Select the rectangle. And add it a gradient color. I remove the stroke because I don't need it. Fill gradient. Not too light gradient. Let's select this color and this something there. Not that bad. It mixed to a relative good gray or strange color there. But this is not the right place. Okay. V on the keyboard to check this tool that we can call move tool. No, what's the name of this? Hey, come on, Photoshop. Come on, the move tool, yeah. Align to canvas in the center and in the center vertically, horizontally, and vertically. Okay, little line, you are not enough long for me. I want to align you in the center of the canvas in a horizontal and vertical way. Come on. Ah, you make me sing. Let's go. Yeah. It's not that difficult, but it looks so difficult. I should go a little bit down there, and you should come there. Okay, let's add a shadow. So I create a new layer. I hit the command button on the keyboard and push this subnail layer there to select my brain. I stay on the layer I create. I hit the command B to use the brush tool. X because I have the white color is selected and I want the black, but Photoshop is looking for something now, so I have to wait a moment. There, no, 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 Come on. I want a pure black. Oh my God, mais it's horrible to wait like that. Command B, just B, and you draw inside the brain there. Ooh, I'm getting hungry. No, it's not possible, really. Photoshop. Thinking to restart the computer one more time. One more time for today. First time. Hey. Come on. It's impossible. I cannot wait like that. The whole day, Photoshop. You have to do it now. It's very simple. Ah. Come on. Let's try to finish the poster. If Mr. Text Tool wants to help me to write something there. Cognitive, I want resources. And let's see what happens. Let's change the disposition here. No, mais it's not difficult. That's not difficult. Yeah. Come on. Move to go there, approximately there. Oh no, done. Woo! Thinking I'll never finish it. Let's go over the I am on the gradient. No. Let's duplicate it. Rasterize layer. Duplicate it one more time because it's rasterized. Come on there. Copy and paste. What happens if I put it over here? It's not that good for sure. Oh, whoa, too much. Here you are, and you are good. make it smaller. No, but what is this shape? What I am doing there? I'll copy that brain again. Make it like this. Behind other elements. And yeah, wait 10 minutes for transform. Yee-hee. So nice. So the plan there is to create a sense of repetition and depth. Depth. Yeah, add layers, superimpose. Brain, geometric shape, brain. I'll show you in a second. Wow. It's really time I change computer. Let's add some geometric shape like circles. I should zoom a little bit because there's something wrong. It's not a perfect square, so it doesn't touch the angle. The angles doesn't touch the lines, so I want them to touch the line. Here we are, and here we are too. Like this. Perfect. Let's cut that shape in the middle. displace it a little bit. There and a little bit there. Okay, I know the little detail will change. Rasterize the line. Command 0 to see the wall poster. Create a new layer above under the lines. Select the lines. Hit Command B. Draw into the line. Once you made it, the goal is to create a shadow for the line. So, Gaussian blur again. Oh. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur, come on, come on. Allez, Photoshop, come on. Gaussian blur. Maybe 79 will be a little bit too high, so too large. All the difficulties in the world there. 53 will be better. Yeah. 50? Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, still waiting, eh? Take your time, Photoshop. Take your time. Don't hurry up your process. Take it easy. Don't be too fast. Take the time you need, because I realize I didn't save the poster. So if you crash now, I'll probably get very angry. Hey, all of that for a Gaussian blur. Now, really, it's not big deal. Just do it. Do it. And I didn't push. Okay, is it serious? Filter, Gaussian blur, progress. I'm sure you progress, and it's so slowly. Whatever, I thank you to progress. It's very nice, I'm thankful for that. It's really awesome. So I thank you. Thank you very much. You done? I can save the file. Up, remove the charge. Saving 0%. Okay. I save you this weight for nothing. Let's try to finish the poster. If Mr. Text Tool wants to help me to write something there. Cognitive, I want resources. And let's see what happens. change the disposition here. No, mais it's not difficult. That's not difficult. Yeah. Come on. Move to go there. Approximately there. Oh no. Done. Woo! Thinking I'll never finish it. Let's go over the I am on the gradient. No. Let's duplicate it. Rasterize layer. Duplicate it one more time because it's rasterized. Click on there. Copy and paste. What happens if I put it over here? It's not that good for sure. Oh, whoa, too much. Here you are, and you are good. Let's make it smaller. No, what is this shape? What I am doing there? I'll copy that brain again. Make it like this. Behind other elements. And yeah, wait 10 minutes for transform. Yee-hee. So nice. So the plan there is to create a sense of repetition and depth. Yeah, add layers, superimpose brain, geometric shape, brain. I'll show you in a second. Wow. It's really time I change computer. add some geometric shape like circles. I should zoom a little bit because there's something wrong. It's not a perfect square, so it doesn't touch the angle. The angles doesn't touch the lines, so I want them to touch the line. Here we are, and here we are too. Like this. Perfect. Let's cut that shape in the middle. Just displace it a little bit there and a little bit there. Okay, I know the little detail will change. Rasterize the line. Command 0 to see the wall poster. Create a new layer above under the lines. Select the lines, hit Command B, draw into the line. Once you made it, the goal is to create a shadow for the line. So, Gaussian blur again. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur, come on. Allez, Photoshop, come on. Gaussian blur. Maybe 79 will be a little bit too high, so too large. All the difficulties in the world there. 53 will be better. Yeah. 50? Okay. Yeah. Okay, Still waiting, eh? Take your time, Photoshop. Take your time. Don't hurry up your process. Take it easy. Don't be too fast. Take the time you need, because I realize I didn't save the poster. So if you crash now, I'll get probably get very angry. Hey, all of that for a Gaussian blur. Now, really, it's not big deal. Just do it. Do it. And I didn't push. Okay, is it serious? Filter, Gaussian blur, progress. Sure, you progress, but so slowly. Whatever, I thank you to progress. It's very nice, I'm thankful for that. It's really awesome. So I thank you. Thank you very much. You done? I can save the file. Up, remove the charge. Saving 0%. Okay. I save you this weight for nothing.
So I'll continue to add some shape here and here, over and in between the brain. Like I said, it's to add depth to the depth to the poster. Like that, it will look like a little bit deep, of course. That's the goal. Oh, come on. No. Ah, God. Yeah. Like this. Oh no, I forget to make you a little bit smaller. Oh no, I restart the computer and I make an update of the Mac OS X softwares, and so now it should be good. Yeah, I put you behind. No, you are not behind. What are you looking for? Here. You too, I want you to be a bit smaller. Here. Just have a little idea. Circle, ellipse, I don't want you. I want a rectangle. I copy and paste. I create a new folder for that. for this shape, and I duplicate. I duplicate. I proceed like that several times. To have a kind of pattern made of lines. Okay, I select them all, and one more time I duplicate them. Like that, it will be a good amount of lines. Done. One more time I select them all. And I want to align them. Align them, distribute the spacing in a horizontal way equally between each of these lines. Here we are. Don't I leave that align section? Command E to merge all of those of these layers together in one. And here is the funny part. Oh, maybe I was about to use a liquify, but maybe it would be nice to warp them there. Yeah. Yeah, looks nice. Let's place you above. Oh, apply the transformation, please, first. Yes, take your time. We are not in a hurry. Okay, if you continue like that, it will take 2 hours at least. Yeah, no, Photoshop? No, well done. Now the line are sick, become sicker. Yeah, let's add another warp effect over the first one. Just finished my coffee, sorry. Yeah, I have the time with that Photoshop with looking for something like transform in progress. Okay, done. Here you are, I select a square, I copy and paste it. I place that things there. Let's do it one more time, there with bigger square. Okay, let's select the old color. I mean the pink and the mint green. And that's done. Cool, not because the okay, fine. Looks fine. Thank you for your services, but I have to fire you. Select again this pattern made of lines. And maybe there is something to do with them, like put it over somewhere. I asked you to move a little bit, yes. Okay, maybe not. I will use lines, use little part of this and place them somewhere there. Okay, looks fine. Come on there. Do the same job. Scener selection. Command C, Command V to copy and paste it. Place it around, maybe horizontal, vertical. Vertical will be perfect. Okay, and you should go up on the layer. Yeah, like this. Yeah. Maybe there. Yeah, fine. Okay, I select this one more time. Copy paste. I think this area is fine and this is too huge there, so it's not okay. Oh no 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 no. What am I doing there? Okay, I select you here. Around here, and you are fine. I copy and paste you. Yeah, it's not that complicated, right? You can do it. You can do it. So I want you now. I want to select you there, but I want a thinner. Don't want that long. Here will be nice. Copy, paste. And I'll place you there. Come on. So now I want this blue. No, okay, what I say, this green mint lines there. And do the same, approximately the same there, but on the top. Hey, that just selection. Okay. Yeah. Oh no, please. Photoshop. maybe I don't like the fact that these are going there. So I will remove you there from there. Yeah. Looks a little bit better now. I duplicate you. Hey, not so bad placement there. But too pink, I think. Huh? So I just have to turn you. Not too much there. Yeah, not bad, not bad. Maybe you should go behind the red gradient. Rectangles. And now let's play with white colors. Ellipse tool, yeah. Oh yeah, I know what I do. Oh, I don't want just a stroke there. I don't want a stroke, I want to fill it with white colors, with white color here. Where are you, my little ellipse? I have to put you up here. Yeah, you look so good. Small and nice, you're a little bit attractive. To the eyes. Yeah, it's a very central composition I have there. And I'll continue to put some element in the, oh, what am I doing? In the center and over the brain. Oh. Come on. Select all the ellipses. Oh, go on the align tool because I want to distribute the horizontal vertical space equally between all of them. I merge them. I'm sure about what I'm doing, so I have to select them. Command E for merge them in only one layer. I duplicate this layer there, just a little bit on the bottom. And maybe one more time in a crazy way. Well, not so crazy, but more behind. Up. I select all of this layer, these three layers, and I distribute the space horizontally that time. Do it. Please do it. Is it made? No, mate, it don't look. Yeah, it looks fine. Okay, fine. Copy them all again. Because I want them there. Yeah, fine, I merge a little bit up. And that's fine. Maybe this rectangle is not fine there. I should play with it, you know. more smaller way or not, I don't know. I will tell you soon if it works or not. We will see that together. Yeah, not really, huh? I can remove you too because I don't need you anymore. I need you anymore. I need you anymore. That means nothing, right? I still need you. And that's what I can do. Because that can be interesting. Yeah. It adds something to the poster. That look good. That look good. Yeah, I think it's relatively fine for sure. There are many works to do, but I already spent enough time for today's poster. So I thank you to come to see what I'm doing for the poster number 600. I thank you very much to follow all along this poster with me, and I see you tomorrow for the poster 600 number 2 on the August 24. See you.